Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of Trend Watch from CompTIA Research, where we give you a little bit of this and a little bit of that from the data that we've been collecting in the technology industry. Today we're going to take a look at IT support. And in our most recent jobs report, the one for January, we found that IT support job postings were the third rated job postings among all technology jobs, coming in behind software development and IT project management. And this is a trend that's been pretty consistent in a lot of the jobs reports that we've looked at month over month. And we think that this is really interesting because IT support is obviously one of the job roles that's been around for quite a while now. I think everyone kind of knows what the help desk is. A lot of companies have their own help desk. A lot of companies might be outsourcing it, but there are a lot of IT support positions out there. So it's really interesting to see that there continues to be such high demand for IT support roles. And we think that there are a couple different reasons for this. One is that companies obviously continue to grow their technology footprint, not in terms of just the technology that they're procuring and the technology that they're installing and implementing, but in the way that they're using that technology and trying to be more strategic about it. So as they're growing out that footprint, the need for having some kind of a first level of defense grows larger and larger. The second reason that companies might continue to pursue IT support is that those roles are really good feeder roles for more advanced roles in technology, whether that's in infrastructure, like a network administrator, or in some other discipline like software development or cybersecurity or data. We're seeing companies more and more use that IT support role that has a broad knowledge of IT systems to move into other roles and try to provide training to those individuals so that they can take the next step in their careers. So if IT support is continuing to be something that a lot of companies are demanding, what exactly are they looking for in candidates for IT support roles? There are three big categories of things that companies are looking for. The first, obviously, is some technical knowledge and some technical skill. Companies are looking for candidates that have a broad knowledge of IT systems so that they can provide that technical support. They can kind of understand what types of issues are coming up and they can either address them directly or they can route them to the appropriate area if it's a bit more of a complex problem. There are other technical skills needed, like in hardware so that you can help users with their equipment, or in software so that you can do installations and you know about operating systems. All of these things really come together and provide a well-rounded candidate, which is why so many companies are using these roles as feeder roles into other things. You know, from the basic knowledge that you have in an area like software or cybersecurity, you can grow that knowledge and step into a software development role or a cybersecurity specialist role. The second category of skills that companies are looking for are durable skills. These are the types of professional skills that everyone needs in their day-to-day job. And we've been putting more and more of an emphasis on durable skills within technical roles because there's been a stereotype of technology positions kind of sitting in the back room or just sitting behind a computer and doing the technology work and not really having to interact with the rest of the organization. That's obviously not true for an IT support specialist. Those people have to interact with the users on a day-to-day basis to try to keep things going. They also have to interact with the extended IT team to understand when it's time to move those more complex and complicated issues up to some more advanced specialists or some people with some more knowledge. And then they can kind of learn a little bit more about what's going on with these issues and how the company builds out its IT architecture. So these durable skills in areas like teamwork and communication and problem solving are really critical for these IT support specialists that play kind of a unique role in interacting with the rest of the organization and also getting a broad knowledge of the technology footprint that a company might have. The final area that companies are probably starting to look for these days more and more is efficiency. Because these IT support specialists are on the front line and because the companies are using technology more and more, they want to make sure that the entire workforce is productive. And so the speed with which IT support specialists can close tickets or resolve issues is becoming really important to companies these days. And this is where artificial intelligence is really going to start playing a role. I don't think that a lot of IT support specialists are going to have to get down into the nitty-gritty of an IT tool that their company might be using, but they're going to have to leverage these tools really in the same way that they would leverage the internet. And so if you think about the way that an IT support specialist might do an internet search these days to try to find out what's the latest around a technology issue or how someone else might be solving a problem, they might need to start kind of leveraging those same types of skills into artificial intelligence. And this means that they have to be aware of how they provide input to artificial intelligence. And this could be in the form of the data that's going into the tool, or maybe even wording the prompt correctly. And in the same way that they might try to word an internet search correctly to get the best information, there's a lot of work going on right now to figure out how exactly do you prompt these AI tools in the best way to get the best output. And then that output is something else that you have to deal with. So when you do an internet search, you get a lot of different links, and you have to kind of figure out which ones are giving you the best information. It's the same case for AI tools. When it gives you an output, even though it looks like a single answer, we've heard a lot about how these AI tools might have hallucinations where they're using their algorithms to come up with an answer that might not be completely correct. And so an IT support specialist has to have enough knowledge to recognize when an answer might be leading them down the wrong path and what to do about it. And then finally, IT support specialists are going to be working with tools like ticketing systems or internal chatbots that probably have AI baked into them. And so they're going to have to become comfortable with using these tools and leveraging these tools to become more efficient in their day-to-day workflow. Obviously, AI is something that's disrupting businesses in a big way, and it's probably going to take place over many years. But it will be really interesting to watch how AI changes this IT support role that doesn't tend to be as deep into the technology weeds, but is going to be leveraging it a lot to do their business. So that's a quick look at what IT support is going to look like over the next few months. We hope that you will join us next time for another episode of TrendWatch.